hurricanes, tsunamis, even a nuclear attack. All very scary and very dangerous emergencies that Hawaii could face. Are you ready? After the missile alert mistake, it became clear that a lot of us don't know what to do in the time of disaster. So we wanted to make it easy for all of us to get prepared. Over the next half hour, we'll walk you through the steps you should take now to make sure you and your family are ready to respond to emergencies of all kinds. We've enlisted experts from government, military, and the community, gathered all the current planning guidelines and supply lists, and we tag along as a local family follows the steps. You can follow along too on our website, khon2.com. We begin by getting you ready for a no-notice emergency.
Authorities are already working on better planning for not just a nuclear scenario, but even chemical, biological, or radiological attack. Other sudden events like earthquakes, fires, flash floods, and mass power outages could happen at any time.
For a no-notice type of disaster, let's say, for instance, an earthquake, we're not going to get any warning of that. It could happen like that.
But there are key differences between this and forecasted weather-related emergencies that individuals and families need to know. First, forget the community emergency shelters. They will not be activated. There are no designated blast or fallout shelters. What might be triggered if there is any advanced notice might be sirens, warning messages from the emergency alert system on TV, radio, and online, and the cellular phone alerts.
Boys, do you hear the siren? Come, right now.
You may have only minutes to take protective action.
So they should take any type of alert seriously, and they should act accordingly.
And those are the get inside, stay tuned.
That's correct.
Get inside means shelter in place. To survive an initial attack, find any possible protection from the blast, shock, and initial radiation. If you are indoors, stay indoors, away from windows. Basements are ideal, or farther into the core of larger structures. If you're driving, pull over safely and stop. If an accessible building is very close, go in there. If not, remain in your vehicle and lie down on the floor. If you are outdoors, immediately get into the closest, strongest building. Stay inside means just that. Remain sheltered until you are told it's safe to leave or 2 weeks have passed, whichever comes first. Short outings could be okayed to get food, water, and medical care. But how will you know? Stay tuned. Listen to local AM/FM radio stations for official information, because it is expected to be the most survivable method of communication. Electromagnetic pulse blasts may render cell phones, internet connections, even some radio and television unavailable. Small, portable walkie-talkies could come in handy.
In my pocket, I keep a transistor radio. I'm one of the, they call me Frank the Dinosaur, because I always have a transistor radio wherever I go.
I have a hand crank radio. That's a really, really important thing to have.
If your kids are at school, do not go to reunite until clearance to do so has happened. This is going to be one of the hardest parts for parents and kids, but it is critical.
Do not rush to go get your children. If it's an attack that's coming, like a terrorist attack or any type of radiological incident that might occur, your school is smart enough and they've got the procedures in place on how to protect the children.
How are you locating the proper place to shelter in place for a missile situation, campus by campus?
So the Department of Education does have a safety, security, and preparedness branch. So they actually go out and assess the situation with the principal, whether within the various drills. But now with shelter in place, we are locating the ones that are shored up, hardened, like, you know, these. There are some schools that have portables, for example. That would not be an ideal location.
Schools are preparing to have kids for as long as 48 hours after an attack, including food and water. Your home should have weeks worth of supplies on hand for all hazards, and we're going over those lists later on. But in your car and at your work, keep go bags that have at least a day, ideally two, of things like water, high nutrition, non-perishable food, clothes, flashlight, radio, and a first aid kit.
Being prepared is not just the responsibility of the government. Being prepared is the responsibility of every individual.
Coming up next, how to get started on building your emergency kits and the growing list of what you need.